could just let me know if my books start catching fire, that'd be great. Oh boy. Today, I learned so I really enjoy checking out some of the most popular potential facts. Disclaimer, they might be false truths. Let's find a good one to start it off. Should I go to the controversial ones? Maybe not, no. That's more gossip. That's a lot more gossipy. Today, I learned that 50 years ago, the sugar industry quietly paid off some scientists to point blame at fat for heart diseases. Sources: NPR. Today I learned that Bob Drain, I guess this is a nutrition themed, today I learned Bob Drain, the founder of Lunchables, won't even feed them to his own children. The healthyhomeeconomist.com is the source for that one. That's, wow. That really says something. It's like how many CEOs of Marlboro and Camel smoke cigarettes themselves. Or better yet, how many multi-millionaires of Miller or Coors or Budweiser, Bud Light, Budweiser, actually drink those beers? I don't, you know, I don't really see them drinking Budweisers. I see them drinking $1,000 bottles of wine. What about that song, Hey Ya, by Outkast? Switching topics, nutrition to music. How many alrights do you think is in that song? Where he says, alright, 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 alright. That's the extent of my groove. Time's up. The answer is only 15. There's only 15 all rights. And hey, I would have guessed like 30 at least. Alright, this next one. There's a disclaimer. It says bad post title, but let's see. Maybe it's just worded awkwardly. Today, I learned. I wonder, am I close enough? You'd think after 2 years I'd be really, really professional about this, but sorry. little glurps in my throat that pop up after I drink. Excuse me. You know what? I'm going to leave that in for the sake of giving a big shout out to ASMarctica, because he had an awesome, very honest and true rant about how slightly irritating it is to have those, especially when you're trying to make quiet videos like this, and you have these little, he called them glurps, I think. Little glurps. That's the last one, because I know it's a weird sound I probably wouldn't like. But, yeah, Arctica. There's one for you. I left that in just for you. No, he's awesome. His videos are so, very, very high quality. Low talking. So I know that probably really must be a wrench in the spokes, or gears, whatever the phrase might be, when that happens to him. So these homosexual lovers, so these guys were homosexual lovers that overthrew a tyrant. Covering these are the history of the Peloponnesian War by Thucydides and the Constitution of Athenians attributed to Aristotle, or at least his school. So their story is, so to Aristotle that would have been like us talking about the founding fathers of America, Thomas Jefferson and Washington, Franklin, Hamilton, and so it wasn't far enough back to be myth, so there was some historical accuracy. That's really interesting. I think it's fascinating that the dainty, flamboyant, generally looked upon as very effeminate, and a synonym for that might be weak. To a lot of people, might interpret it that way. I just think it's an interesting juxtaposition. Masculine nature of, or not the masculine, but the more warlike predisposition, such that they actually overthrew a tyrant, which no doubt means they murdered a lot of people. And Greek and even Roman culture. I think it's interesting that all these very masculine figures, heroes, that apart from the fact that they had gay sex or gay interracial, I mean, I don't think, I definitely read that race was actually not just a very prominent idea or concept in a lot of people's minds in ancient Greece, which is very interesting, you know, that in what we would think is a natural progress of humanity, 2,000 years after, that race was more of a demarcation, a stronghold of discrimination than it was 2,000 years ago. So I think that's, I don't know, to me that's why studying history is interesting. It's like all these things that you wouldn't, that you would normally clump together. And I was just talking to my sister last night about things that go together, like a pairing, synonymous terms, homosexual and effeminate, ancient and less civilized, or less civilized and more, you know, racist, I guess, less, more close-minded, but in all honesty, it's fascinating, so, that you could have these powerful warriors that most men would look up to nowadays, but little did they know that they were all, a lot of them were homosexual, because they probably had very intimate connections when you're under siege and you're about to die and be murdered in a very brutal way. The comfort of another, especially one who has your back in war, is a profound thing, so it's an interesting concept. And I think a justifiable one in certain circumstances. Moving on. Today I learned a high-altitude nuclear explosion would cause an EMP, or a electromagnetic pulse. The ionized electrons' interaction with the Earth's magnetic field releases cyclotron radiation. I have no idea what that is. That middle button's very, very loud. Now it gives me a power with respect to time differential equation. The emission of each electron can be calculated as the negative differential of voltage with respect to time. It's been too long since I looked at those equations. But a cyclotron radiation is, or the phenomenon of cyclotron radiation is electromagnetic radiation emitted by accelerating charged particles deflected by a magnetic field. Force of the particles acts perpendicular to both the magnetic field lines and the particles' motion through them. Okay. So that's a three-dimensional picture of the interaction of an electron in of a moving electron inside a powerful magnetic field, which there's no way I could, I need to make another another physics episode where I draw. Recipes.howstuffworks.com. This is kind of funny. Today Hours episode of The Late Night with David Letterman, where all the voices were dubbed from English to English by the Speed Racer Dubcast, with Peter Fernandez as David Letterman. That's funny. Let's see if we can click on that if it's not too loud. Maybe I can have you guys listen to it real quick. Oh, nice. Had a hard time understanding that, but anyways, it equates to about 50 cents, half a dollar in electricity cost to share 1 gigabyte. So wow, in a way, when I download movies for a really nice Blu-ray, you're still paying $4 or $2 if you torrent. I guess you're not. Or am I? What's the source of that? I'm getting dubious all of a sudden. Real dubious of that one. The source is ACEEE.org, which is some electrical engineering. It's asking me to download a PDF, guys. Should I do it? Yeah, I'm gonna do it. Going out on a limb for you guys. Oh. Okay, there's my answer. Only 38% of the costs are borne by the end user, which, while the remaining costs are thinly spread over the global internet through which the data travels in switches, routers, signal repeaters, servers, and data centers. This creates a societal tragedy of commons where end users have little incentive to consider the other 62% of costs associated and associated resources. Interesting. Wow. So the data centers take on half of that. This one for sure. I love stuff that has to do with massive phenomenon in the ocean. That rogue waves were thought to be near mythical until one was actually recorded in 1995. I'm curious search Wikipedia or Reddit. much now. That's my new baby, right there. I saved up for 5 months to get that, by the way. And that's all my dirty clothes that I usually have out of frame. Anyways, in that mirror right there is so I can see the screen, make sure I'm still in frame, and make sure my face is still somewhat high res. But that right there, that's the rogue wave. You can see my favorite band that you all hear. Today you learn that at the beginning of every one of my videos is Ports of Canada. Whoa. Got it zoomed in. Oh, that was weird. That was very intimate. Oh, the song is 5978, by the way. Since a lot of you, or quite a few of you, at least once a month, someone asked me, which I am humbled and very grateful to be able to share that beautiful, beautiful music. All right, here's a couple last few ones for you guys. The founder of Alcoholics Anonymous demanded whiskey during the last few days of his life. Who can blame him? it's in their retina, and they can detect the Earth's magnetic field. They can detect the presence of it, and of course that guides their direction north and south. show you that my universe sandbox got -1 dislikes. How about that? Do you like my mouse pad? My universe sandbox. -1 dislikes. Off the charts. How does that even happen? Okay, guys. Thank you so much for dropping by. I gotta get ready for work. Please feel free to comment. Let me know, like I said, what you like. I always take into consideration what to do by reading the comments, and more importantly, I just get super motivated and really happy. I get pumped when you guys tell me how much